Jesse Burnett was 14, 16 years I managed him. I never even thought I could be a manager. Jackie McCoy, my coach, made me quit boxing because I got hit quite a bit, and he didn't want me to get hurt or talking with no sense. So he told me, it's time for you to retire at 30, and I had a real good record, and in my amateurs, I was world amateur champion, so I knew how to fight. But I didn't look like I teach now, jabbing, and I was a winger, but I let him go, but I had power. So you just, through these hardships, in Compton, when they had the riots, I'm probably the only white guy that could walk down that street, because that gym was so popular. People would come in and watch me spar. Ken Norton was there, Bossman Eddie Jones, Andy Hawk Price, every one of them, Hedgman Lewis. I'd come home, I'd be driving on that freeway, that Hedgman Lewis, I can't figure that guy out. I'd have a black eye or a busted lip. And then one day I came in, I was a little sick, and I told Jack I was gonna fight a main event at the Olympic Auditorium. And he says, you're gonna box with Hedgman. I go, oh, Jesus, Jack. I never made an excuse. I said, I don't feel that good. I don't want to go home all busted up. He said, he ain't gonna bust you up. He's gonna work with you, And that's like saying, what are you, nuts? And so that day, I don't know how it happened or what, I knocked him out. And so he, for 2 years, he beat the heck out of me. That one time I cracked him and I got him. Whatever, however it came, I tell my son all these stories, and my son says, I got to meet this Hedgman Lewis. So he's in Vegas one time with Eddie Pudge. And he walks over to Hedgman, and he goes, Hedgman, I'm Jesse Reed Jr. Jesse Sr. is my dad. He said, that goddamn dad of yours knocked me out. He didn't say anything about how many beat the hell out of me. He said, he knocked me out. So I realized that in my mind, that it isn't who you are, how good you are, it's how far you want to take yourself, and how much you believe in yourself. So pain in your life, to me, is a reward. I was made the Hall of Fame. I told the microphone, I said, I want to thank my Uncle Rocky Rodia, because he taught me what it is to be tough, and he really did. I was 13 years old working on a rubbish route. And I look at everything that's negative, you make a positive out of it, you've done something. Well, I'm looking at a lot of positive. And I have my positive right in front of me. And so I know that boxing is great, because it teaches you have to make your choices. If you're not good enough, I've never had a fighter knocked out. I've had them knocked on their butt and get up. I'm not gonna do it. I'm being insane to be, you're out for 10, because that takes everything out. I don't think it's that's what's important. What I think is important, because you have a loss, if you can come back from that loss and figure out a way to win, you've won. You won bigger than just like Mayweather. I'll give you an example. Floyd Mayweather Jr., I trained his uncle Roger, who was I had to be the psychologist of the year to make him champion. But he was a good fighter. And Roger ended up training his nephew. And how he got that job was I'm part of it. And the reason Floyd Mayweather was never out of shape is because he got his ass clean from Paul Spadafore, my fighter, who wasn't even a puncher. And it's on the phone. I put it on there to teach you a lesson. And I'm told his letter, his management, Paul has had his problems in life, but he's one thing about him, he's got a heart of a mountain. And I said, so Paul looked at me and he said in Vegas, he said, Jess, what do you think about me and Floyd Mayweather? His father came to me and bragging about they only need to take one round to take care of me. That hurts my feelings. He says, I want to buy. I says, Paul, you're fighting Cardona in 2 weeks. If you get a cut, Al McCauley and all those guys are going to be throwing me out as a trainer. I want to train you. You're a great champion. He said, I don't care about that. I can't stand all that talk. So I told him, okay, let me sit you down. I sat him down like I did with Jason. And Jason knows these stories. And And I tell them if they're in a fight, I let them know the truth. This is a fight, but this is a growing fight. So I told Paul, I says, Paul, what do you, he says, I don't like all the criticism, all the mouth. I said, that's what we're going to capitalize on. They think you can't punch. You're not going to punch him in the head. Nobody's ever ripped that body like you're going to do. You match him with speed. You have the same coaching that I taught Roger what he knows. So Roger, believe me, he'll know. But he's in trouble. My father don't know it, but Roger knew it. And Roger sat back and was, well, he knew that Paul Spadafore was better than what they thought. They were all talking. About 300 people come to the Golden Club gym that day. And Paul goes, gee, man, Chris, but I said, hey, this is going to make your life. Believe me, he was a great champion. And Paul not only beat him mentally, physically. I asked Leonard, his manager here, about 2 months ago. Wouldn't it be nice to let Floyd have a chance to do an exhibition and Paul get $4 million and he gets his 60 and nobody loses any, but you get a chance to get a piece of Paul? And I mean, Paul didn't live like Mayweather, but Mayweather lived clean from what Paul did to him. Paul went the other way, but Paul now is with me and he's doing it. He's making a change. And I've bet my money that he'll beat Mayweather after death. Because he's got that in his mind already. And sometimes talk don't win the fights. It's what's inside of a person. And Paul came from the Keys Rocks. He came from a tough neighborhood. He was around a lot of tough situations, and he survived. His mother was a crackhead. His brother died of overdose of drugs. His dad died. And that's what Johnny Tapia went through. And I really learned a lot being around kids like that. Camacho, I trained Camacho when he beat Sugar Ray Leonard and Duran. And I that makes me, and I'm not bragging, that makes me proud in my heart.